So Mummy is not right in the head.
That's weird.
There was five stories last week of five different magazines on the front cover. One about sex, one my nose has fell off, one that I'm trying for a baby. My job just got to me.
Where did you get to, Kez? Where did you end up?
Went to a hotel, no one knew where I was. And I was like, I don't want to do OK magazine. Can't be asked answering all these questions. Oh, why was your mother going through a divorce? And I just want to forget it all. I just want to forget that week. Put it in a box.
Send it away.
And just start afresh. But I'm Kerry Katona. That doesn't happen. I don't want to be Kerry Katona anymore. Kerry Katona, Kerry Katona, Kerry Katona. Changing my name.
Oh, I just want to go to the pub.
Right, OK. Shall I get out of the magazines and have a look at him? She's going to see it sooner or later, so... All right, speak to you soon. Bye. I just had a phone call off Sean. And in the magazines today, Pat sold a story to Heat. And then in Closer, a brother, Roy, has done one as well. Just knowing your own sister has sold a story.
What are you doing?
All right, sit down. What's going to tell you?
Come here. No, tell him from here.
Sean's just been on the phone.
What?
Pat sold a story to Heat, and Roy's done one to Closer.
Roy, you don't even know Roy.
I know you're expecting it to come, but...
No, I'm used to it by now.
But it's your sister at the end of the day, Kerry.
Oh, yeah, I'm just letting her do it.
Anyway,
what's our partner got to say?
About your child or your dog.
On the hotel does.
Front cover of Heat.
Was it out already?
Today.
Front cover of Heat, 3-year-olds with a fag in your mouth, Sean said.
Oh, fucking on her ass. I'm on front covers again. Popular as ever. Well, people like to read about me, I guess. I'm not going to pack and leave in the middle of the night like I did last time. I follow my mum. That's what my mum says.
Hello.
Hiya. Have you seen it? You're pissed off. I think I felt like she'll press outside again. Another fucking story on the front cover again. I love you too. Bye. What pisses me off? How they all go,
no.
It's Mark that's destroying it. It's Mark. Do you not realise it's them that's destroying me? It's them that's selling the stories on me. It's them that's betraying my trust. Mark's not sold a story. No, our Pat has. That is brilliant.
She's took it really well, but the more it's going in, the more upset she's getting about it. And how can Kerry...
The amount of times that she's been on camera, and so I never do that. I love Kerry and Mark, and she always had two-faced people out, doesn't it? Ah, Pat, I fucking can't believe it. Go away, please.
Go away, please.
Grown up talk.
Oh, I can't believe it. Goes on about Mark's just destroying your life, saying that you need to spend more time with the kids, that she'll sit and drink cheap Lambrini in a room.
I do drink cheap Lambrini. Not a cheap date. That's a weekend, so what's wrong with that?
Your life ended when you spoke with Brian because you loved him so much. What's wrong with him?
Get over fucking Brian McFadden, for fuck's sake. Jesus Christ, it's 5 years ago. 5 years ago? Fucking hell. as the first fucking 5 minutes
goes on about how you used to see your mum slash her wrists, and that it wasn't uncommon to see you in the pub.
Pals fear Co could lose everything, including her kids. I was reported twice to social services and that killed me, being brought up in care. And social services and the police everywhere I took girls' school. I saw fucking social workers sit in the room with my kids on their own, that killed me. Story, it shouldn't even affect me, but it does. There's always how much you can take. It's every fucking week. Kerry car crash TV, troubles, Kerry.
I just can't do it.
Oh.
I'm coming.
How's your nose, by the way? Have you had some surgery on that?
Yeah, I've had surgery on my nose, yeah.
Oh my god.
Ladies and gentlemen,